Good morning, student. Myself, Professor Gada KSS from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. So, friends, we are learning the subject that is solar and wind energy from the final year of mechanical engineering. Okay. So, in the last lecture, we have seen some topics from the unit number 1. So, in the today's lecture, we are going to see the topic from the unit number 2. So, the unit number 2 is basically solar thermal system and its applications. So, related to the solar energy, we have seen some concept from the unit number 1. Today, we are going to discuss some topics from the unit number 2, that is the solar thermal system and applications. So, we are going to start the unit number 2. So, let's see what we have to see particular topics from the unit number 2. So, in the unit number 2, the topics which we have to learn are what is a solar collector. That means that second unit is totally depends on the points, that is the solar collectors. So, different types of solar collectors also we have to see. What is solar collector means what? That also we have to see. So, what is the use of that solar collectors? Which are the different types of that solar collectors, how that solar collectors are work, that total we are going to see in the unit number 2. So, first topic we have to see, that is what is a solar collector. Second one, application of solar collectors. That means the different types of solar collectors are there, but which collectors is suitable for which application, that also we have to see. That means we have to see the different applications of solar collectors also. Then third point we have to see, that is the types of solar thermal collector. That means different types of solar collectors are there. So out of that, which types are suitable for our human beings applications, that we are going to see. Next point we have to see, that is a flat plate collector analysis. That means one of the important types of solar collector, that is the flat plate collectors, that we have to study in the details in the unit number 2. Then we have to see the next collector, that is the evacuated tube collector analysis. That point, evacuated tube collector analysis, also we have to see in the details. That means two types of collectors we have to see in the details, that is flat plate collectors and evacuated tube collectors. Then we have to see solar air heater and its types. So, how that solar air heaters are working, which are the different types of solar air heaters, that also we have to see. Then next one, solar distillation. So, how that solar distillations are working, that also we have to see. And last point we have to see from the unit number 2, that is the solar concentrating collector with its types. That means, firstly we have seen flat plate collector, evacuated tube collectors. That's are non-concentrating types of the solar collector. But along with that two collectors, flat plate collectors and evacuated tube collectors, we have to see more types of collectors that belongs to solar concentrating collectors. So, there are different types of solar concentrating collectors are there. So, which are that we are going to see in the details from the unit number 2. I think all of you have got the proper idea about what we have to learn in the unit number 2. So, let's start one by one all the topics. So, firstly we will see first point, that is the what is the solar collector. So, basically as the name solar collectors, solar means solar energy and collectors means receiving the energy or absorbing the energy from the sun radiations. That is nothing but the solar collector. So, the elements which are receiving or absorbing the solar radiation or solar energy, that is called the solar collectors. And they are converting the solar energy into the electrical energy or some other useful of energy, that is nothing but the solar collector. So, solar collector is one of the important point or one of the important components from the solar panel or solar system. All of you understand that? So, let's see what is the actual definition of solar collector. A solar collector is an object that is used to collect energy from the sun. Why that are used? To collect the energy from the sun, which it does by absorbing solar radiation and converting it into the heat or electricity. That means that collectors are absorbing or receiving the sun energy and converting it into the form of the heat or into the electricity. That's are nothing but the solar collector. So all of you have got the proper idea about solar collector. Then next, what they have said about solar collectors: the material types and coating on a solar collectors are used to maximize solar energy absorption. That means on that solar flat plate collectors or different types of collector, there will be the some coatings of some materials, and why that coatings are provided? To increase the rate of absorption of the sun energy. Okay, that means maximize the solar energy absorption. Then next, the use of these solar collectors provide an alternatives for traditional domestic water heatings. That means one of the application they have given where we are going to use the solar collector. So first main type where we are going to use the solar collector, that is nothing but the domestic water heating. Then using a water heater, then potentially reducing energy cost over the time. That means due to that water heaters, the energy of heating the waters are get saved. That means the cost of the energy required to heat the waters, that is the reduced with the help of solar water heater. All of you understand that? Then next, as well as in domestic setting, a large number of these collectors can be combined in array. That means number of solar collectors are combined in the solar water heaters and that are used to generate the electricity and in the solar thermal power plants. That means solar power plant doesn't consist of the single solar collectors. All of you understand? That means there are number of solar collectors are used in the solar thermal power plants. All of you understand? So with the help of number of solar collectors, we are doing the solar thermal power plants. All of you understand that? So that is nothing but the solar collector. So next, see what are the applications of the solar collector. So there are different applications of solar collectors are given. That are the solar water heating system. First one is the application of the solar collector is used in the solar water heating system. That means for heating the waters, we are using the solar collectors. Second one, solar space heating and cooling. So for the heating of the space and cooling, we are also using the solar collectors. Then solar refrigeration is one of the application of solar collector. Industrial processes heat. So heat required for the industrial processes, that is also used by the solar collectors. Then solar thermal power system. So solar thermal power system, in that system solar collectors are also used. That means there are different applications of the solar collectors. So that solar collectors are used in the such applications. All of you understand? So that's are some applications of the solar collector. So we have seen what is the solar collector and where that solar collectors are used. All of you understand? So next we will see some basic components of the solar water heating system. So one of the application we have seen where solar collectors are used. So first application we have seen, that is a water heater. So though the water heater is application of the solar collectors, so actually where that solar collector is located in the water heating system, that we are going to see in the detail. So see, one diagram is given. So in that diagram, the basic components of solar water heating system is given. So if we see in the serially, we will see first storage tank. Okay, so from the storage tank, cold water supply is given to the solar panel. All of you understand? So cold water supply is given to solar panel. So before that, in between water storage and the solar panel, there is a pump and controller. So why that pumps and controllers are there? To regulate the flow of cold water to the solar panel. All of you understand that? Then in the solar panel, there will be the solar collectors. They have shown here solar collectors. So what that solar collectors are doing? They are absorbing the sun energy or sun radiation and transferring it to the cold water which we have supplied to it in the solar panel. All of you understand that? And with the heat, help of that heat, that water get heated, and that output of the solar panel is nothing but the hot water. So that hot water again given output. All of you understand? That means input is a cold water and output is a hot water. So it is done with the help of solar collector used in that system. So that is nothing but the basic components of the solar water heating system. All of you understand where solar collectors are used or solar collectors are located in the water heating system? So next, see, there are different types of solar thermal collectors are there. All of you understand? So where, what is the work of that solar collector, that we have seen. Then which are the applications of solar collectors, that we have seen. Then where that actually solar collector is located in one system, that is the solar water heating system, that also we have seen. Then now we will move toward the actually types of different solar thermal collectors. So basically in the types of solar collectors, two types of solar collectors are there. First one, non-concentrating collectors, and second one, concentrating collectors. Non-concentrating and concentrating collectors, that are the two types of solar collectors. All of you understand that? So in particular, non-concentrating collectors and concentrating collectors, again there are different types of solar collectors. So in the non-concentrating types of collectors, basically two types of collectors are there. First one, flat plate collectors, and second one, evacuated tube collector. It is also noted in the star term as a ETC, that is a evacuated tube collectors. All of you understand? In non-concentrating collector, there are two basically types of collectors, flat plate collector and evacuated tube collectors. So again, there are two types of evacuated tube collectors, that is the direct flow evacuated tube collector and heat pipe evacuated collector. So when we are seeing in the details that flat plate collector and evacuated tube collector, at that time we will see how that flat collectors are seen and evacuated tube collectors. Okay, so we will see the details about that two types of collectors when we are seeing the non-concentrating collectors particularly. Then here we are going to understand which are the different types of concentrating collectors also. Non-concentrating we have seen two types, flat plate and evacuated tube collectors. Now in the concentrating collectors, there are again four types. First one is a CPC, then parabolic dish, parabolic throw and the solar tower. That's are the four types of the concentrating collector. So let's see what is particular CPC. So if you see the below, there are given long form of that CPC. So CPC is nothing but compound parabolic concentrator. All of you understand? Compound parabolic concentrator, that is the first point or first type of the concentrating collector. Second one, parabolic dish. Then third one, parabolic throw. So parabolic throw, that's are the HTF. So HTF means what? Heat transfer fluids. So heat transfer fluids are there. So parabolic throw, HTFs are there. So three HTFs are there: SAF, molten salt and DSG. So what is the SAF? SAF is nothing but the synthetic aromatic fluids. All of you understand? Then molten salt is there, and last one, DSG. DSG means what? Direct steam generations. That's are the types of the parabolic throw. All of you understand? And last one, types of the concentrating collector is nothing but the solar tower. All of you understand? So solar tower is one of the concentrating collectors. Totally four concentrating collectors and two non-concentrating collectors are there. So when we are seeing non-concentrating collector, at that time we will study in the detail flat plate collector and evacuated collector. Then when we are seeing the concentrating collector, we are going to see or we are going to study in the details four types, that is CPC, parabolic dish, parabolic throw and solar towers. So that's are basically the types of the solar thermal collectors. So what we have seen in the today's lecture, we have seen that in from the unit number 2, which point we have to cover. Then we have seen what is a solar collector, what are the different applications of solar collector, and actually we have seen in the one particular system, solar water heating system, where that solar collectors are located or what is the work of that solar collectors. Then we have seen at the last different types of solar collectors. So basically concentrating solar collector and non-concentrating solar collector. Two types of non-concentrating solar collectors are there. and four types of concentrating solar collectors are there. So in the next video we are going to see in the details on non-concentrating collectors, that is two flat plate and evacuated tube collectors, and in the next video we are going to see in the detail concentrating collector, that is a CPC, parabolic dish, parabolic throw and solar collector. So friends, we will stop here for the today's lecture. Next point we will continue in the next video.